President, I would like first of all to congratulate the rapporteur, Mr. Kacin, and his shadow rapporteurs for the work they have done so far. I regret to see the EU-facilitated Serbia-Kosovo talks fail after 6 months of negotiations. The talks today are a last chance before the April Council meeting to reach a clear agreement on the outstanding issues. However, it's not up to the EU to impose solutions. Never before has the EU future of Serbia been more at their own hands. It is a matter of maturity for Serbian political leadership and society. The choice EU or Kosovo is a detrimental concept, polarizing society and jeopardizing the EU accession path of the country. It could finally lead to a result which is neither EU nor Kosovo. I have to remind that there are other important items on the EU agenda, as outlined in the EP resolution. Guaranteeing democracy and the functioning of democratic institutions, upholding the rule of law, ensuring respect for human rights, protection of all minorities throughout Serbia according to European standards, maintaining good neighbourly relations and regional cooperation. Optimism is needed, and I finish by saying that 22nd of April Council will mark a new beginning for Serbia. Thank you. President, I'd like to commend both High Representative and Vice President Ashton and Commissioner Fule for their efforts to maintain the credibility of the enlargement policy, doing their utmost to facilitate an agreement between Serbia and Kosovo and bring the enlargement process forward. I'd like to express also my expectations that the talks between Prime Ministers Dačić and Tači today will be successful. An opportunity for a historical breakthrough in the Serbia-Kosovo relations is within reach and should not be missed. However, there is a need for more transparency in communicating the outcomes of the Belgrade-Pristina dialogue and involvement of Parliament and civil society. Building public trust in the process is of paramount importance. Kosovo authorities should make further efforts with regard to the reconciliation process and reach out to the Serbian minority, particularly in the north, so as to ensure broad integration within society. At the same time, Kosovo Serbs should use all means provided by the Constitution to play a constructive role in politics and society. The European Parliament report outlines a number of other important issues on the EU agenda of Kosovo, such as the rule of law and functioning of the democratic institutions, including the judiciary, fight against corruption and organized crime, economic and social reforms, public administration reform, etc. I remind that there is a renewed commitment on the side of the European Union to further assist Kosovo, among the other aspirant countries, on its path towards EU integration through the Instrument for Pre-Accession Assistance for the period 2014-2020. I have to underline, however, that the whole process will be significantly accelerated and improved if all remaining EU member states take the step to recognize Kosovo, and I call on them to do so without further delay. Thank you.